Dear students, today we are coming to the derivation of Maxwell's equations in EMFT. First we are taking the first equation in differential form. We consider a surface S bounding total charge consisting of free charge and polarization charge. If rho and rho p are the charge density of free charge and polarization charge respectively, at a point in a small volume element dv, then according to Gauss law, closed integration E vector dot ds vector is equal to 1 upon epsilon naught closed integration rho plus rho p into dv. Equation number 1. We know that polarization charge density rho p is equal to minus divergence p vector, where p is the electric polarization. Then equation number 1 becomes closed integration E vector dot ds vector is equal to 1 upon epsilon naught closed integration rho minus divergence p vector into dv, or closed integration over surface epsilon naught E vector dot ds vector is equal to closed integration rho dv minus closed integration divergence P vector dv. By using Gauss divergence theorem in LHS, we get closed integration divergence epsilon naught E dv is equal to closed integration rho dv minus closed integration divergence P vector dv, or closed integration divergence epsilon naught E plus P into dv is equal to closed integration rho dv. Equation number 2. Replacing epsilon naught E plus P by electric displacement vector d vector, closed integration divergence d vector dv is equal to closed integration rho dv, or closed integration divergence d vector minus rho into dv is equal to 0. Equation number 3. Since volume dv is arbitrary, so it cannot be 0. Therefore, divergence d minus rho is equal to 0, or divergence d is equal to rho, or divergence d symbolically is equal to rho. This is the equation number 1. In free space, volume charge density rho is equal to 0. Then equation first is reduced as divergence d is equal to 0. Equation number 5. This is the final equation. Thank you.